friends, I am Rashmi. Welcome to SRS Info. Today, we will discuss some important MCQs of General Studies. The first question, which of the following lakes, also known as Kheetum Lake, has been added to the list of recognized Ramsar site? So, Ramsar sites are the recognized wetlands under the Treaty of Ramsar, which is known as Ramsar Convention. Ramsar Convention, it was an international treaty for the conservation and sustainable use of wetlands. And this treaty took place on 2nd February 1971 at Ramsar. And Ramsar is a city in Iran. So that these recognized wetlands are known as Ramsar site. Okay. And 2nd February, every year we celebrate World Wetland Day. And we have different themes on this day in different years. The theme for 2020 was Wetlands and Biodiversity. Okay. And the theme for the World Wetland Day 2021 is Wetlands and Water. Wetlands and Water is the theme of World Wetland Day 2021. Okay. And currently, India has 42 Ramsar sites. And the question here is Kheetum Lake, which is a Ramsar site. And this Kheetum Lake is Sur Sarovar. Okay. Sur Sarovar is in Agra, which is in UP. So the Kheetum Lake, which is added to the Ramsar site, is Sur Sarovar. And there is a sloth bear rescue facility is available in Sur Sarovar. 42 Ramsar sites in India. You have to remember the latest one. Sur Sarovar is the 40th one, 40th Ramsar site. Okay, the 41st, which is Lonar Lake, Lonar Lake in Maharashtra. Lonar Lake in Maharashtra is the 41st Ramsar site, which is recognized in India. And the latest, which is 42nd, this is Sokar. Where is Sokar? It is in Leh district of Ladakh. Okay, 40th is Sur Sarovar and 41st is Lonar Lake in Maharashtra and 42nd is Sokar, which is in Leh district of Ladakh. Okay, then what about Wular Lake? Wular Lake in Jammu and Kashmir, and this is designated as Ramsar site in 1990. Wular Lake recognized as Ramsar site in 1990, and this is the largest freshwater lake in India. And Chilka Lake, which is on the east coast of India. This is on the east coast of India, which is in Odisha. Chilka Lake is located in Odisha at the mouth of Daya River. Chilka Lake is a lagoon. This is a brackish water lagoon and largest coastal lagoon in India and second largest lagoon in the world. Okay, this is the largest lagoon lake in India and second largest lagoon in the world. And Chilka Lake was designated as Ramsar site in 1981. So the answer is Sur Sarovar, Kheetum Lake. Okay. Which of the following organizations observed its 59th raising day on 24th October 2020? So 24th October every year, Indo-Tibetan Border Police celebrates its raising day. Why? Indo-Tibetan Border Police raised on 24th October 1962. As a wake of Indo-China War. It was formed after Indo-China War, which took place in 1962. This organization patrols the border of Tibet with India. Then, this is the part of Central Armed Police Force. Central Armed Police Force. Okay, and this Central Armed Police Force is under the Home Ministry. And who is the Union Home Minister? Amit Shah is the current Union Minister of Home Affairs. And CAPF is coming under the Union Home Ministry. And see, there are seven child organizations of CAPF. The first one is Border Security Force, BSF, which guards Indo-Pakistan and Indo-Bangladesh border. The second one is Central Reserve Police Force. This is the largest organization which is working under CAPF. And this Central Reserve Police Force assists the states and union territories in police operation for maintaining law and order. Okay. And the third one is Central Industrial Security Force. The Central Industrial Security Force provide industrial security, organization securities, and protect internal infrastructures like airports, and it gives VVIP protection. All these are coming under this Central Industrial Security Force. The fourth one is Indo-Tibetan Border Police Force. I have already explained to you. This guards the Indochina border. And the fifth one is Sahastra Seema Bal. Sahastra Seema Bal guards Indo-Nepal and Indo-Bhutan border. Okay, Indo-Nepal and Indo-Bhutan border guards by this Sahastra Seema Bal. Then the sixth one is National Security Guard. This is also called as Black Cats. National Security Guard, this is a counter-terrorism unit which combating the terrorist activities and protect against the internal disturbances in our country. Okay, the seventh and last one is Assam Rifles. Assam Rifle is the oldest paramilitary force in India. It was formed in 1853 during British. And this Assam Rifles guard Indo-Myanmar border. Okay, these are the seven child organizations under CAPF. So the answer of this question, that is, on 24th October 2020, ITBP, Indo-Tibetan Border Police Force, observed its raising day. And now the current chief is SS Deswal. SS Deswal is the current chief of ITBP and the headquarter is New Delhi. Okay, and what is the motto of ITBP? That is Shauri Dridhita Karmanishta. Shauri Dridhita Karmanishta is the motto of ITBP. Next, who was the youngest member of parliament in the 17th Lok Sabha? So the current Lok Sabha is 17th Lok Sabha. And who is the youngest member of this 17th Lok Sabha? She is Chandrani Murmu. There is a small mistake here. C-H-A-N-D. Okay, Chandrani Murmu. Chandrani Murmu is the youngest member of parliament in the 17th Lok Sabha. Okay, and her constituency is Keonchar. Keonchar is in Odisha and she represents Biju Janata Dal. Okay, and she won against BJP member, that is Anant Nayak. Okay, she defeated Anant Nayak of BJP and won, and her constituency is Keonchar, which is in Odisha. She is the youngest member of parliament in the current 17th Lok Sabha. Clear? Then what about Nusrat Jahan? She is also MP of the 17th Lok Sabha and she is a Bengali film actress basically. Now she is the MP of 17th Lok Sabha and her party is Trinamool Congress and her constituency is Basirhat. Basirhat is in West Bengal. And Mimi Chakrabarty, she is also from Trinamool Congress. She is also a Bengali actress and a singer. And her constituency is Jadavpur. Jadavpur is in West Bengal. She is also from Trinamool Congress Party. Okay. She listed as the most desirable woman in 2016 by the Calcutta Times. Okay. And Tejasvi Surya, he is also MP of 17th Lok Sabha. And his constituency is Bangalore South. He is from BJP party. Okay. And do you know who was the youngest member of 16th Lok Sabha? That is in the last Lok Sabha, Dushyant Chautala was the youngest member of parliament of 16th Lok Sabha and his constituency was Hisar in Haryana. Okay. And his party was Indian National Lok Dal. So here the answer is Chandrani Murmu. Sorry for the mistake. Chandrani Murmu. C-H-A-N-D-R-A-N-I. Next, which is the first state in India to use space technology and artificial intelligence for safeguarding government lands? This is a very empowering initiative, very interesting initiative taken by the government of Odisha. The Odisha government is the first state in India to use space technology and artificial intelligence for safeguarding government lands, especially in Bhubaneswar. Bhubaneswar is the capital of Odisha. And basically, this is to monitor all government lands in Bhubaneswar. And this technology is known as BLUIS. What is BLUIS? Bhubaneswar Land Use Intelligence System. Bhubaneswar Land Use Intelligence System. This is the name of this technology by which The government of Odisha will monitor all the government lands in Bhubaneswar city. Okay, and this is a geotagged repository system. Geotagged repository system, and this is used by high resolution satellite imagery. This become possible by using the high resolution satellite imagery, and Odisha becomes the first state in India to use this space technology and artificial intelligence for safeguarding government lands. Next, which Indian cricket ground hosted first ever test match held in India? Very interesting question. Which Indian cricket ground hosted first ever test match held in India? So, the first ever test match held in Bombay Gymkhana Stadium, which is in Mumbai, and the test was conducted on 15th December 1933 between India and England. Okay. The captain of Indian team was C.K. Naidu. He was the captain of the team of India in that test cricket match. By the way, Bombay Gymkhana Stadium was established in 1875. Then, what about Chepauk Stadium? Chepauk Stadium is also known as M.A. Chidambaram Stadium. This is M.A. Chidambaram Stadium, which is located in Chennai. This stadium was established in 1916. And what is the importance of this stadium? Bombay Gymkhana Stadium was the host of the first ever test match held in India. But M.A. Chidambaram or Chepauk Stadium was the host of the Indian test cricket, which was the first ever cricket victory. Indian cricket team's first ever test cricket victory in 1952, which was against England. Okay. And this match took place in this Chepauk Stadium. Okay. Then what about Eden Gardens? Eden Garden is the oldest cricket stadium in India, which was established in 1864. Okay. And this is the second largest cricket stadium in India after the newly built Sardar Patel Stadium, which is also known as Montera. Where is it? It is in Ahmedabad. So, Sardar Patel Stadium is the largest stadium in India, and Eden Garden is the second largest stadium in India, and this is the oldest one, okay, which was built in 1864. And Eden Garden is known as home for Indian cricket, batsman's paradise, and also Mecca of Indian cricket. Why it is called as Mecca of Indian cricket? Because this Eden Garden was the first officially built cricket stadium in India. The stadium which was built specifically for cricket. This was the first stadium like that. That is why Eden Garden is known as Mecca of Indian cricket, also known as batsman paradise and home for Indian cricket. Okay. And you know that Montera Stadium in Gujarat, this is the second largest stadium in the world. Okay, second largest in the world. So, which one is the largest in the world? That is the first one in the top list, which is Melbourne Stadium. This is the largest cricket stadium in the world. Melbourne Stadium is in Australia. What about Firozshah Kotla? By the way, Eden Garden is located in Kolkata. Okay, Kolkata. And Firozshah Kotla Stadium is in New Delhi. Now it is known as Arun Jaitley Stadium. This was also one of the oldest stadium in India, and this was established in 1883. Next, the Python Hydroelectric Project is on which river? So, the Python Hydroelectric Power Project, which is also known as Python Jayakwadi Hydroelectric Power Project. Is on Godavari River. And this project is in Maharashtra. Okay. So the Python Hydroelectric Power Project is in Maharashtra, which is on Godavari River. So there is a dam here, that is the Python Jayakwadi Dam is there. And by this dam, they create this hydroelectric power project. Okay. So this dam is one of the largest earth dam in Asia, which is an earth dam and one of the largest in Asia. And this dam was inaugurated in 1976. By the then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. But the foundation stone was done by Lal Bahadur Shastri in 1965. And then there is a lake which is called as Nag Sagar Lake. This Nag Sagar Lake was formed by this dam. Okay. By this Python Jayakwadi Dam, there is a lake was formed. That lake is known as Nag Sagar Lake. And this lake is fed by Godavari and Pravara rivers. Godavari and Pravara rivers. This Nath Sagar lake is the largest irrigation project in Maharashtra. Okay. And there is a garden near this lake, that is Jnaneshwar Garden, which resembles the Brindavan Garden in Mysore. Okay. This is on the banks of this Nath Sagar lake. And this garden is one of the largest garden in Maharashtra. Clear? And this Nath Sagar lake, there is a bird sanctuary is also. This lake is actually is a reservoir, okay? And so this Jaikwadi bird sanctuary is also here. Jaikwadi bird sanctuary is also near this Paithan Jaikwadi hydroelectric power project, that is on the Nath Sagar lake. Clear? Then there is a thermal power project, that is Parli thermal power project. This is in Maharashtra. And this Parli thermal power project get the water resource from this dam. Okay. The primary source of water to the Parli thermal power project is this Paithan Jaikwadi dam. Clear? So the answer is River Godavari, where the Paithan hydroelectric power project can be seen. What are the main dams on Narmada River? Sardar Sarovar Dam, Indira Sagar Dam, Omkareshwar Dam, Maheshwar Dam, all these are in Narmada River. Sardar Sarovar, Indira Sagar, Omkareshwar, Maheshwar. Okay, all these dams in the Narmada River. What about Mahanadi River? The longest earthen dam in the world, which is Hirakud. Hirakud Dam is on Mahanadi River. Then in Kaveri, there is Krishna Raj Sagar Dam, Methur Dam, Kallani Dam. All these are in Kaveri River. Okay. So the answer of this question is A. Godavari. Next, which city in Pakistan is called the Gardens of the Mughals or City of Gardens? So where you can see the Shalimar Garden. Shalimar Garden is located in Lahore. So Lahore was the center of Mughal Empire. Okay. And this Lahore reached the height of its splendor under Mughal Empire between the 16th and 18th century. So Lahore is known as the Gardens of Mughals or City of Gardens. Okay, and now this is the second largest city in Pakistan. Okay, now Lahore is the second largest city of Pakistan and this city is known as Garden of Mughals. So which is the largest city in Pakistan? That is Karachi. Okay, and now the Karachi is the fashion capital of Pakistan. This is also known as City of Lights. The City of Garden is Lahore and City of Lights is Karachi. And which is the most important airport of Pakistan? That is Jinnah. Jinnah International Airport is located in Karachi. Okay. And most important seaports in Pakistan, what are they? There are two most important seaports in Pakistan. One is Karachi Port, of course, Karachi Port, the port of Karachi. And the second is Port Bin Qasim. Both these ports are also in Karachi. So Karachi is a very important city for Pakistan. Then Multan. Multan is also an important city of Pakistan. And this is the capital of the Multan division in Punjab. Okay. And this city is located on the banks of Chenab River. Multan is located on the banks of Chenab River. And this Multan was one of the most important trading centers of medieval Islamic era. Medieval Islamic era. Trading center. Then Peshawar. Peshawar is the capital of Pakistani province of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Okay. And in the ancient time, it was the capital of Kushan Empire. Peshawar was the capital of Kushan Empire during the period of Kanishka. There is a Kanishka Stupa. There is a Kanishka Stupa in Peshawar. And this Kanishka Stupa was one of the tallest building in the ancient world. This was one of the tallest building during the ancient world. So Peshawar is historically very important city. Okay, all these cities are very important. So the answer is Lahore, City of Gardens. City of Light is Karachi. Next, which of the following, also known as EduSat, the first dedicated educational satellite of India? Okay, so the first dedicated education satellite of India is EduSat, which is the other name of GSAT-3, geostationary satellite of GSAT-3. Okay, and GSAT-3 was launched on 20th September 2004 by ISRO from Satish Dhawan Space Center. Okay, and is launched into the geosynchronous transfer orbit. Geosynchronous transfer orbit. And this was the first dedicated education satellite of India, and this was the turning point in the field of distance online education in India. So this is very important. And in September 2010, this EduSat satellite was decommissioned. Its objectives and its functions was over, and it decommissioned, and it was relocated to graveyard orbit. What is graveyard orbit? Graveyard orbit is the junk orbit or disposal orbit. Those satellites which are not in use or whose functions are over, these satellites are relocated into this graveyard objects. Okay, so now the EduSat is in the graveyard orbit. And what about GSAT-4? This was an experimental satellite. This is also known as HealthSat. This is known as HealthSat. It was launched in April 2020 by ISRO, but it was a failure. Why it failed? It failed during the rocket's third stage, which is known as upper stage. Okay, this was failed to reach the orbit after the rocket's third stage malfunctioning. But one point to be remembered is that the third stage was the first Indian-built cryogenic-fueled upper stage. This was the first Indian-built cryogenic-fueled upper stage. Even though it was not successful as an experimental way, it was a good trial by ISRO. Okay, and what about GSAT-1? This was also an experimental communication satellite which was launched on 18th April 2001. From Sriharikota. Again, it failed to achieve its target orbit. Then what about GSAT-2? It was a successful operation. It was launched on 8th May 2003 by ISRO. The rocket was GSLV MK1D2. Okay, and this positioned at geostationary orbit successfully. Clear? So the EduSat, the first education satellite of India, is GSAT-3. Next, which of the following pairs of folk dance forms and states is not matched correctly? Not matched. Okay. Here are some folk dance forms and here are some states. You have to choose which is not matched correctly. That is the wrong one. Okay. Let us look one by one. Lezim. Lezim is the folk dance of Maharashtra. This is correct. Okay. Basically, there's a musical instrument which is called as lezim or lezim. And there is another musical instrument that is dholki or drum. So both these music instruments are used in this folk dance form. By this instrument, this dance form got its name, that is lezim. And this is one of the most popularized folk dance of Maharashtra. Clear? So this is correctly matched. Okay. Some other forms of folk dance of Maharashtra are tamasha, lavani, dahi kala, etc. Then next one is Maharasa. Again, Maharasa is one of the famous folk dance of Manipur. This is also correctly matched. And Manipuri, Lai Haroba, all these are the other forms of folk dance in Manipur. Then what about Natti? Natti is again the folk dance of Himachal Pradesh. This is also correctly matched. Basically, Natti is the folk dance form which is practiced in the western and central hills of the Indian subcontinent, and this dance form is the primary native of Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. And this Natti folk dance is listed in the Guinness Book of World Record. Why? Because as the largest folk dance, the Natti dance is enlisted as the largest folk dance in the Guinness Book of World Record. Okay, and in Himachal Pradesh you can see Luddi dance and Musra. Luddi dance and Munsra. These are the other folk dance forms of Himachal Pradesh. So this is also correctly matched. And the last one is Ghumar. Ghumar is performed in Jharkhand? No, it is the folk dance of Rajasthan. Okay, Ghumar is the folk dance of Rajasthan, and this is performed by Bhil tribe. And this tribe performed this dance for the worship of goddess Saraswati. So this pair is not matched. Here the question is, which is not matched correctly? So our answer will be option D, Ghumar, Jharkhand. Okay, and you can see Kalbelia, Khayal and Julan Leela. These all are the some of other folk dance forms of Rajasthan. Okay, so now our answer is option D, Ghumar, Jharkhand. The last one, which among the following was the first musician to be felicitated with Bharat Ratna? Most important question. The first musician to be felicitated with Bharat Ratna. She is the great M.S. Subbulakshmi. She was a great Indian musician, classical singer from Madurai. Madurai is in Tamil Nadu. Okay. And she won Bharat Ratna in 1998. And she was the first musician from India who received Ramsen Magsaysay Award, which is also known as the Nobel Prize of Asia. And she received this prize in 1974. Okay. And she was the first Indian who performed in United Nations General Assembly in 1966. Okay. And many other awards she received. And some of them are, she got Padma Bhushan in 1954, Sangeet Natak Academy Award in 1956, Padma Vibhushan in 1975, Kalidas Samman in 1988, and Indira Gandhi Award for National Integration in 1990. Okay, Bharat Ratna in 1998. So the first musician to be felicitated with Bharat Ratna is M.S. Subbulakshmi. She was born in 1916 and she died in 2004. Okay, then what about Lata Mangeshkar? Again, she is a great Indian musician. She is also known as the Queen of Melody. Queen of Melody. Voice of the Nation, Voice of the Millennium, etc. All these are the other names of Lata Mangeshkar. Okay, and she got Dada Saheb Phalke Award in 1989. Okay, and she also received Bharat Ratna in 2001 after M.S. Subbulakshmi. Okay, and she also got 3 national awards and many other. Then Ustad Bismillah Khan, again, he was also a great Indian musician. He was born in 1916 and died in 2006. Okay, and he popularized Shehnai instrument. Shehnai instrument is a musical instrument popular only in Indian subcontinent. But Ustad Bismillah Khan popularized this Shehnai instrument all over the world. Okay, and he got Padma Shri in 1961, Padma Bhushan in 1968, Padma Vibhushan in 1981. And he also received Bharat Ratna in 2001. Then what about Pandit Ravi Shankar? Pandit Ravi Shankar was a sitar musician. He popularized sitar and he also received UNESCO International Music Council Award. He received UNESCO International Music Council Award in 1975 and he is the recipient of 5 Grammy Awards. He nominated for Academy Awards also. And Pandit Ravi Shankar was the first recipient of Tagore Award. Actually, Tagore Award was established in 2011. Okay. And Pandit Ravi Shankar died in 2012. He got the first Tagore Award in 2013 posthumously. Okay. And he died in United States. And he also received Bharat Ratna in 1999. M.S. Subbulakshmi got it 1998. Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, Sangeet Natak Academy Awards, Kalidas Samman, Ramsen Magsaysay Award, all these are received by Pandit Ravi Shankar also. Okay, so here the first musician to be felicitated with Bharat Ratna is M.S. Subbulakshmi. So now we completed 10 MCQs. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching.